Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, and thank you very much for coming to the Intercultural Dialogue Institute grand opening ceremony. Mesdames et messieurs, bonjour à tous. Today we have a fun-filled program scheduled as part of the Ottawa Turkish Festival, and as well as commemorating and celebrating this grand building you have in front of you. The Intercultural Dialogue Institute building property, the property we stand on here today, was purchased back in 2006. So since then, this has been a dream of the community to establish this building, and we are very happy to have achieved it today. The Intercultural Dialogue Institute provides many activities in the forms of dialogue and as well as reaching out to different communities. We hope that this building will further facilitate those programmings and as well be home to a multitude and very different activities. To commence the programming here today, I'd like to welcome a Turkish dance troupe to perform Zeybek. Zeybek is a dance from Western Anatolia. It is a word derived from the ancient Turkish language, meaning a wise person. Later, it was applied to a class of respected community warriors who were similar in some ways to the Japanese samurai. As an Aegean region dance, the Zeybek displays movements signifying self-assurance, dignity, and bravery. The dance was inspired by the flight of the eagle, a bird much revered in Anatolia. Zeybek is usually thought of as a masculine dance. Please welcome the Blue Star Dance Troupe.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to Zeki Mavi Yıldırım. Prime Minister of Canada, the Right Honourable Stephen Harper has sent the following message for the grand opening ceremony. I am pleased to extend my warmest greetings to everyone attending the grand opening ceremony of the Intercultural Dialogue Institute building in Ottawa. This special occasion offers a wonderful opportunity to highlight the significant role the Institute has played in the nation's capital. Since its founding in 2006, IDI has been committed to the principles of discussion, the productive exchange of ideas, and the celebration of Canada's rich diversity. Like all worthwhile endeavors, creating the centre requires a great deal of hard work and cooperation. I would like to commend everyone who contributed to the project's success. On behalf of the Government of Canada, I offer my best wishes for continued success with your initiatives. The Right Honourable Stephen Harper, Prime Minister of Canada. Thank you very much, Prime Minister. We'd also like to recognize the following dignitaries for their congratulatory messages. Honourable Thomas Mulcair, Leader of the Official Opposition, New Democratic Party of Canada. The Honourable Jason Kenney, Minister of Employment and Social Development and Minister of Multiculturalism. Honourable Bob Shirelli, Ontario Minister of Energy, and Mayor Jim Watson, City of Ottawa. Thanks again. Now I'd like to invite our area councillor, Councillor Alan Hubley from Canada South, to the podium for a speech, please. Please welcome Councillor Hubley.
Thank you all very much for being here today. This is a very outstanding turnout and a beautiful day for the opening of the Institute. I want to congratulate the doctor and his team on the effort here. We've been working together for several years. I remember meeting back with you, it's got to be 4 years ago now, talking about what you wanted to do, and you described your dream, and I could see it in your eyes that this was going to happen and it was going to be a beautiful place. And so to get to be here today with you for the opening of this is quite an honor. And I hope you're very proud of your hard work here. So congratulations and welcome to our community.
Thank you very much. Now I'd like to call upon Councillor of Canada North, Councillor Marianne Wilkinson, a dear friend of the community. Please welcome Councillor Wilkinson.
Much. I've been involved with the Intercultural Dialogue for many years now, and had the great privilege of going to Turkey with you in 2008 and bringing back the enormous flag that you don't have room to put up here because it's so big. But I've been to many of your events over the years and really support the work that you're doing, because there's nothing more important in a country like Canada where you have so many different cultures about that we work together, because we all share the common purpose of living in a democracy with freedoms that give every group that comes here the ability to follow their culture while being important members of Canada. The mayor has left to go to China, so he's not here today. I'd like to ask Councillor Hubley to come up, because we have a certificate from the mayor to present. I'd like to ask, as a local councillor, I think that Councillor Hubley should be the one that reads out the proclamation.
Ottawa Turkey's Festival Days, October 5th to 13th, 2013. Whereas Turkey is one of the birthplaces of civilization, and in celebrating Turkey's heritage, we celebrate human culture in all its grandeur and diversity. And whereas the hospitality of the Turkish people is well known and celebrated around the world, and whereas the symbol of the Turkish festival, the tulip, is also the symbol of Ottawa and stands as a symbol of friendship between nations and culture, and whereas the goal of the festival is to contribute to Canadian society by by bringing communities together in a spirit of dialogue, compassion, cooperation, partnership, and community service.
Therefore, I, Jim Watson, Mayor of the City of Ottawa, hereby proclaim October 5th to 13th, 2013, Ottawa Turkish Festival Days, signed by Jim Watson, Mayor.
Thank you very much for the proclamation and to the City of Ottawa for recognizing Ottawa Turkish Festival. Ottawa Turkish Festival was established back in 2007 as a one-day event, and since then we've grown into 2 days, 3 days, and now we celebrate it over a week. So thank you very much for all of our sponsors, the City of Ottawa, Canadian Heritage, as well as different private sponsors have made this festival possible. A big round of applause for all of our sponsors and volunteers here today for the festival. Now I'd like to call up Dr. Yoel Zabik, Chairman of the Intercultural Dialogue Institute, Ottawa Chapter. Please welcome Dr. Zabik.
My dear distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank God we all saw the date of the opening ceremony. Today, we are so proud that we have a finished project in front of our very eyes. The groundbreaking ceremony for the Intercultural Dialogue Institute took place in September 2012. Some of the prominent guests who were here to show their strong support were Honorable Moyen Balanchi, Member of the Parliament for Ottawa Vanier, Mr. Royal Gallipoo, Member of Parliament for Ottawa Orleans, Mr. Jack McLaurin, Member of Provincial Parliament for Carlton, Mississippi Mills, Mr. Bob Wilson, Member of Board of Directors from the Ontario Trillium Foundation, and Councillor Marianne Wilkinson from Kanata North. The Intercultural Dialogue Institute building has now become a reality for the cultural communities. The Institute will become a center to foster cultural understanding and dialogue amongst ethnic groups by offering educational, social, and youth programs to people from diverse communities. It will provide essential services for newcomers to settle into Canadian society and move into the workforce. This facility will build bridges across cultural communities and contribute to peaceful coexistence among them. IDEA Ottawa will work with local authorities and community leaders to get their advice in order to provide better programs and activities. The project cost us $3 million. We offer many thanks to the Ontario Trillium Foundation for their contribution of $500,000 via the Community Capital Fund. We also thank our local community members who made tremendous donations to make this all possible. Some of them are Mümin Yavuz, Zekeriya Han, Fergan Şık, Arif Akman, Abdullah Açıkgöz, Harun Arapan, Ersin Türkeli, Kerim Han, Hayrettin Büyüktepe, Taner Yıldırım, Bilgin Akın, Ahmet İlkmen, Demir Topçuoğlu, Hikmet Aşmen, Ahmet Kaya, Ergün Yavuz, Harun Kalaycı, Mustafa Şaşal and Mustafa Gurgu. This facility belongs to the people of Ottawa, and thus we continue serving people for generations to come. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Zeybek, and thank you very much to all of the contributors and all of the supporters that he has actually listed in his list. Another big round of applause for all of the people that made this building possible. Next up, we have another dance, this time coming from the Black Sea region. It's called Karadeniz by the Blue Star Turkish dance troupe. Karadeniz dance from the Black Sea region depicts the life of the fishermen on the powerful Black Sea. Dynamic folk dances from the Black Sea coastline, which is pinned against lush and rugged mountains, express the vigor and impatience of the people in the region. They are usually danced collectively with rapid and rhythmic movements. Harsh nature and unpredictable sea life is also reflected in these dances. These are called horon. Dances are typically accompanied by the double drum, Lurna, Shrill Pipe, and the Kemençe, Lira. Please welcome the Blue Star Turkish Dance Troupe.
Saatin köseyi boyunca dolaşmayı, karın dinlemesinde ben asla konuşmayı.
Thank you to the Blue Star Turkish Dance Troupe for joining here at the festival. The group has actually traveled all the way from North Carolina to be here today. Next, I would like to welcome MPP Jack McLaren, MPP for Carleton Mississippi Mills. Please welcome Mr. McLaren.
Well, it's a real privilege to be here with you today, people. I would say this is the riding I represent for all the Mississippi Mills, so I'd like to welcome the Turkish people and the Intercultural Dialogue Institute here to our community. Dr. Yavuz Zeybek has kept in close communication with me over the last couple of years, especially since you started the construction of your building. We were here last year at the sod turning. And it's a real privilege to be here with you today to celebrate the completion of your beautiful new building. I'm sure you'll be having a lot of activities that I look forward to finding out what they are, Yavuz, and I'm sure you're going to call me and invite me to some of them. I would look forward to that. My office, I should tell you, is very close. It's on this street, but one block down that way. And Yavuz will be calling on me regularly, I'm sure. So I'll have no excuse for not coming by to visit you folks. So anyways, thanks very much everybody for having me here today. Congratulations on this wonderful day, your festival, your new building. I look forward to coming and visit you when you ask me to come. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. McLaren. I'd also like to encourage you to follow us on Twitter at Ottawa Turk Fest, and we've established a special hashtag for today, hashtag Turkish Fest. So please feel free to follow us on Twitter and to tweet about what's going on here today. Next, I'd like to introduce and welcome another dear friend of the community, member of Provincial Parliament, Honorable Yasser Naqvi from Ottawa Centre. Please welcome the Honorable Yasser Naqvi.
Thank you very much, Kareem, and good afternoon, everyone. This is a very exciting day. It is exciting because today you're seeing a completion of a dream of a community who has worked extremely hard to make this center happen. I still vividly remember the day 5 years ago when Dr. Zeybek and Kareem Khan came to see me, and we sat down and we talked about their dream, which is to build an Intel Dialogue Cultural Institute, where they actually had the, I gotta tell you, the drawings look exactly what the building you see behind me right now, which is so exciting that this project has come through. And through that meeting and many more after that, step by step, minute by minute, hour by hour, the community worked together. I'm really proud that the Ontario Trillium Foundation, which is the agency of government of Ontario, participated in making that dream come through by investing some of your hard-earned money into this project, which is definitely going to make our community even a better place to live. So it's my great honor to be here to congratulate the community. I also want to bring greetings on behalf of our Premier, the Honorable Kathleen Wynne. Unfortunately, Premier Wynne was not able to attend today, but she really wanted to extend her best wishes to the Institute, to the Turkish community in Ottawa, that we're so fortunate to have this center built right here in the community. And I was going to ask Dr. Zebek and Karim to please, they can come forward and I can present the greetings from the Premier and on behalf of all my colleagues in Ottawa to our community, and congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Yasir Naqvi. Next up, I'd like to introduce and welcome Mr. Bob Wilson from the Ontario Trillium Foundation, board member for the Ontario Trillium Foundation. Please welcome Mr. Wilson.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Bonjour à tous et toutes, and salam alaikum. It's a pleasure for me to be here this afternoon to join you. As has been mentioned, my name is Bob Wilson, and I've been a volunteer with the Ontario Trillium Foundation for 9 years now, so I've seen all the benefits that the Ontario Trillium Foundation can make to communities across Ontario. As Mr. Naqvi mentioned, the Ontario Trillium Foundation is an agency of the government of Ontario. I'm very delighted today to be joined by the Honorable Yasir Naqvi and the MPP from the region, Mr. Jack McLaren. Thank you guys for coming out. I'm constantly amazed at the amazing projects that the Ontario Trillium Foundation is able to help out, and this just ranks up there as one of the very best. In 2011, the Government of Ontario asked on the Ontario Trillium Foundation to administer this capital community fund, and we were very, very pleased to take it on. We support projects around Ontario that help all of Ontario's not-for-profit organizations. We help them to deliver programs and services to diverse cultural communities. And the focus here on inclusion of all the communities and engagement of all the diverse cultures was an important part of the Ontario Trillium Foundation jumping in and supporting this initiative. The $550,000 grant, the $500,000 that was awarded here, was obviously well received, but it's a lot more than just the steel and the windows and the concrete. It's about the people and the ability to adapt, to innovate, to embrace new strategies here. I just want to harken back to a year and a month ago, when we did the groundbreaking ceremonies, and I remember at the time that right down here, right near the bouncy castle, there were mounds of dirt, and all the young children were there playing in the dirt, and I couldn't help but think at the time, a year from now they won't have to get dirty, they'll be able to use this magnificent new facility. So, congratulations to the Intercultural Dialogue Institute from the Ontario Trillium Foundation. Our best wishes and congratulations.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wilson. Next, I would like to welcome Ms. Guljan Akoz, Charge d'Affaires from the Turkish Embassy in Ottawa. Please welcome Ms. Akoz.
I would like to congratulate Mr. Yavuz Zeybek and all his team for their dedication. Bir cümlede Türkçe söylemek istiyorum. Büyükelçimiz Ottawa dışında olduğu için bu toplantıya katılamadı. Fakat en iyi dileklerini gönderdi. Bu büyük, ilk defa, Ottawa'da ilk defa açılan Türk merkezine için çabalarınız için sizi ayrıca kutluyorum.
Thank you very much, Ms. Akoz. Last but not least, I'd like to invite another great dear friend of the community, the Honorable Marla Balanjay, Member of Parliament for Ottawa Vanier. Please welcome Mr. Balanjay.
Put up with folks, but I'm very happy to have had been offered the occasion to say a few words. Salam alaikum, merci de l'invitation. Premier message, Dr. Zeybek, it's a message of congratulations. This has been your dream, it's happening, and now it will be providing an opportunity and a place for people of all backgrounds to learn about each other, to help build up a great Canada that we know. So you, and I want to congratulate too the builders. I'm told it was the McDonald Brothers because I've had a chance to look inside and the details, it's fascinating. The doors are magnificent. You look at the ceiling in the main room, you'll look at the stars and the moon, and I think it's going to be quite a pleasant place to come and visit quite often. And I'll finish that show, Dr. Zeybek. And you know, a building is very much like a country. It's got to build, you have to have a good foundation, you have to have good ingredients, you have to have good airing of ideas and things like that in it. And this is a very good reflection of Canada. We are now engaged in a rather interesting debate with an initiative that has been tabled in the Legislative Assembly in Quebec. And it has caused ripples throughout the country, and especially here in Ottawa, where every single recognized party in the House of Commons has condemned the initiative. And what we're seeing here today is proof positive of the value of multiculturalism, of diversity in Canada. Because it goes beyond that. It goes beyond that. It goes beyond diversity. It also has to include acceptance and respect. And I tell you, I've been dealing with Dr. Zeybek for a number of years now, and what I've always witnessed from him and the Intercultural Dialogue Institute is acceptance, open-mindedness, and respect. And I think as long as whoever is in this country demonstrates that kind of behavior, we will all contribute to making it an even better country. I, on behalf of my leader, Monsieur Trudeau, who said he might want to come and drop in someday, so we'll have to talk there, Dr. Zeybek. He apologizes for not being able to be here as well. But he exemplifies, through his declarations, indeed, the spirit of openness, the spirit of respect, the spirit of celebrating and not hiding Canada's diversity. Félicitations, and may this be a very productive endeavor, as I'm sure it will be. Félicitations.
Merci beaucoup, Mr. Belanger. Next, we'd like to welcome another dear friend of the community who has gracefully joined us here today. The ambassador of the ambassador of Bosnia-Herzegovina. Please welcome the ambassador of Bosnia-Herzegovina.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, hello everyone. I feel really privileged and honored to be invited to this event, and thank you International Intercultural Dialogue Institute for the invitation extended. Looking at this wonderful and remarkable building behind, it really takes first vision, dream and spirit to take you to the long, long trip and road in order to finish it with all hard work that has been invested to finish it with this remarkable building that we have behind us. I wish you all many years and success. I wish that this building will not be only the building, beautiful and remarkable, but also be the gathering place for all the nations, all the people of goodwill who are willing to come and share their time and visions of peace and nice life in Canada here. I know that the Folkro group that is already prepared, I can see them from Bosnia and Herzegovina. I greet you all. And this wonderful weather that we have today also says everyone and everything is cooperating today. So enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your kind word and very well speech. We have another dance, Turkish dance, coming up. It's called the Zeybek. Actually, yeah, we've already seen the Zeybek, so it's called Kafkas. Kafkas is from northeastern Anatolia. It is a dance from the northeastern Anatolia, northeast parts of Turkey as well, characterized by the increasing speed and difficulty of the music and dance. Kafkas portrays the society's beliefs and customs, such as holidays, prayers, funerals, and other aspects of life in times of love, peace, honor, jealousy, and bravery. The music and instruments of the area bring to life the dances performed by both males and females. The aesthetics of the dance include speed, agility, and the ability to maneuver the body in tune with the increasing speed of music. Please welcome the Blue Star Dance Troupe. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to the Blue Star Turkish Dance Troupe for their performance. A reminder that we are also on Twitter. You can follow us at Ottawa Turk Fest. And the hashtag for today, for the Ottawa Turkish Festival, is Turkish Fest. So please join us on Twitter as well. Next up, I think this is the moment of opening for the building just behind us. I'd like to invite up our guests, our dignitaries, for the ribbon cutting ceremony. Please join us, Councillor Alan Hubley, Councillor Marianne Wilkinson, Mr. Bob Wilson, Dr. Yobu Zeybek, Mr. Jack McLaren, Honorable Yasir Nakvi, Ms. Gülcan Akol, Honorable Murat Belanger, Mr. Saadettin Özcan, President of the Anatolian Turkish Federation, Anatolian Heritage Federation, and Mr. Zakaria Khan, member representing the Turkish community. Ms. Biana Gutic Belitsa, Master of the Bosnia-Herzegovina. Thank you very much, folks. So this is the grand opening for the Intercultural Dialogue Institute. I'd like to remind you of the remaining program. We have the Bulgarian Folk Dance Group that will take stage at 1:15 inside. Please do grab a copy of your festival schedule.